هيا على الفلاح.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today, I'm addressing you, the person who's been affected with sickness and illness. I sincerely pray for you by saying, شفاكم الله وعافاكم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you cure. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you miraculous recovery. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you good health. May Allah grant you a speedy and complete return to normal health. And may Allah make you even better than what you were before. You who are ill, you who are sickly, remember every droplet of patience would earn you a great reward. So be patient. Be calm. Take your medication. Call out to Allah alone. Ask Allah to cure you and make sure that you are doing whatever the experts have told you to do. Subhanallah. Sickness is also a gift from Allah. It should be drawing you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every aspect of that relationship. So your prayers and so much more. Your speaking with Allah. Many of us don't communicate with Allah. We speak to Him through dua, through supplication, through complaining to Him about our own weakness and asking Him to strengthen us. May Allah grant you cure. لا بأس, طهور inshallah. May Allah grant you purity. May Allah grant you that which is a blessing from Him. May something good come out of this illness. And inshallah, you will be back to normal. Remember, be very, very firm in your conviction regarding a Shafi, who is the curer, the owner of cure, Allah. Allahumma shfi anta shafi. La shifa'a illa shifa'uk. Shifa'un la yugadiru saqaman, wa la summan, wa la alama. O Allah, grant cure. You are indeed the owner of cure. There is no cure besides your cure. Cure that would eradicate all pain. It would eradicate all sickness, all illness, all disease. May Allah truly grant you cure. My brother, my sister, we are part of one huge family known as the Ummah. The Ummah, this beautiful nation. We are Muslimin. We are believers. We are humankind. Remember, we're reaching out to you today with a dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly grant you patience. And may He grant you shifa. That patience we're talking about, many of us have tasted sickness and disease and illness. Perhaps not just like what you have right now, but remember that conviction, the faith that you have in Allah. Allah will grant you cure. And if Allah does not grant you cure, subhanallah, the fact that we were patient and we kept remembering Allah and praising Him and glorifying Him, that would earn us paradise. At the end of the day, we all have to return to Allah. I have to go back to Allah, and so do you. There are people who were not sickly, who've already returned to Allah suddenly, either through an accident or some other means. And us who are ill, let's make peace with Allah. Seek the forgiveness of Allah. May Allah grant us all forgiveness. Because if Allah forgives us, we will earn Jannah and paradise without reckoning. And subhanallah, remember to send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We usually are taught to say, sallallahu ala Muhammad. But in a better way, in a more prolonged way, we can say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. And there are so many other ways of declaring that beautiful, beautiful thing known as salawat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, like we say, today, we are visiting you through the screen. Yes, it is a sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to visit those who are sick and ill and to pray for them. So here we are. This is a visit to you, my brother, my sister. We love you so much. We care for you. Here we are. We feel your pain. And that's the reason why I truly, from the bottom of my heart, reach out to all those who are sick and ill and say, O Allah, grant my brother or my sister, Ya Allah, grant them cure. Ya Allah, safeguard them. Let their health return in a miraculous way to better than what it was. Pure cure. May Allah purify all of us. About jinn affecting them. People complain about magic affecting them. People complain about someone doing something against them. I've spoken in the past about how we should not be thinking in these superstitious lines, but, mostly you are to blame. You who are complaining, hold a portion of the blame. Why? Have you read what is known as your mu'awwidhat? Do you bother reading the verses of the Quran that have within them the protection of Allah, because that's the word of Allah? Have you read every morning and every evening what is known as Ayatul Kursi? Do you know what it is? Do you know what are the adhkar of the morning and the evening, the remembrance of Allah and the words of praise of Allah and the seeking of protection in Allah from shaitan and from that which is harmful? Have you read that after every prayer? Do you pray? Do you dress appropriately? Do you have a relationship with Allah, the protector? You don't have a relationship with the owner of protection, and you want protection. Subhanallah, no relationship. When last did you pick up the Quran? When last did you obey the instruction of Allah? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, let's get to the mu'awwidhat. You read Ayatul Kursi thrice, every morning, every evening. You read the last three surahs of the Quran, if not at least the last two surahs of the Quran, called the mu'awwidhat. Those surahs within which we're seeking the protection of Allah from shaitan, from mankind, from the evil of mankind and jinnkind. We're seeking from the whispers of the devil and so on. When last have you read the few prayers? Rabbi a'udhu bika min hamazati shayateen wa a'udhu bika rabbi an yahdurun. Oh my Lord, I seek your protection from the whispers of the devil, and I seek your protection from the devil even coming into my presence. When last have you repeated that prayer? A'udhu bi kalimati Allahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. I seek the protection in all the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil that He has created, the harm of that evil. Bismillahi alladhi la yadurru ma'asmihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama'i wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. In the name of Allah, with whose name nothing can harm on earth nor in the skies, and He is indeed all-hearing, all-knowing. When last have you said these? You're supposed to be saying them morning and evening, and even after every prayer, it's recommended to read Ayatul Kursi. Subhanallah. We don't do this, and then we complain, oh, I was affected, I'm seeing things, I'm hearing things, I am here, I'm there. Subhanallah. At times, it might just be a bit of stress and anxiety and so on, but in order to protect yourself from shaitan, from the unseen that we believe exists, and from jinnkind and so on, and from people tampering with you through superstitious items, remember to read your mu'awwidhat. Read your adhkar morning and evening. Absolutely important. If you haven't, you are foolish. Subhanallah. And some people say, well, you know, I was on my monthly cycle, so I couldn't read. The women. Subhanallah, no excuse. All schools of thought permit the recital of these mu'awwidhat even during your menstrual cycle. Subhanallah. So remember, my brothers, my sisters, not a day should ever go by without you having read those mu'awwidhat morning and evening. Seek the protection of Allah. Oh Allah, protect me. Do you know there is a hadith which says, من نزل منزلا فقال أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق لم يضره شيء حَتَّى يَرْتَحِلَ مِن مَنْزِلِهِ ذَلِكِ. The Prophet ﷺ says, whoever is entering a home or a place and says the following supplication, أَعُوذُ بِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ التَّامَّاتِ مِن شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ, and I've translated that already, nothing will harm that person until he leaves that home or that place. So as you're entering, read the dua. You're entering someone's home, you don't know them, read the dua. You're entering your whatever, any place, anywhere. You're out, maybe driving, you stop somewhere at a rest room or wherever it may be. Subhanallah. Another thing, when you're entering and exiting the bathroom in order to relieve yourself, do you know that there is a dua to be read? There is protection that you need to seek. A'udhu billahi min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. You know, you're seeking protection in Allah from certain shayateen and jinnkind. Subhanallah. So we don't do that and then we complain. But Allah says, I taught you in advance how to save yourself, how to protect yourself. Brothers and sisters, put on the armor. Put on that armor. Nothing will harm you. Everything that comes in your direction will deflect, go away. Nothing will touch you. That is the strength that Allah has asked us to actually strengthen ourselves with. And He's given us that as a gift. May Allah protect all of us from shayateen and grant cure to those who are struggling with something of this nature. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen those who are already affected. And sometimes, if we are affected, be strong. Continue in your supplication. And slowly but surely, these forces will become weaker and weaker and they will depart. They will leave. At times it takes a bit of a while, but be determined. Have that conviction. Fight it. And Allah will grant you the strength. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.